thankfulness all the time. But that's it. Thankfulness is an attitude. Thanksgiving is an action. If you take the word, see, it says giving is an action. So we come at this time to give thanks. It means that we do something. Now, there are two things that I kind of observed as I looked through this. The first thing is this. Thanksgiving is not natural. You know, that we don't naturally thank. That's something that we teach our children, and that we have been taught as children, and sometimes
young children,
and sometimes adults, that we're supposed to be thankful, that we're supposed to be thankful. And so, you know, we tell a child, say thank you, tell them thank you, tell them thank you. But now, we're always instructing them to tell them thank you in response to something. Thanksgiving is a response. You notice there that we read in Psalm 16, I love the Lord because he has heard my voice and my plea for mercy. Because he inclines his ear to me. Therefore, I will call upon him for as long as I live. And then in verse 12, he doesn't use the word for because, it's the word for, but that's what it means. What shall I render to the Lord for? Because of all his benefits to me. And he says, I will offer to you the sacrifice of thanksgiving and call on the name of the Lord. I looked and read some references. In Psalm 135, 5 and 6, it says, I have trusted you in your steadfast life, love. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. In Psalm 52, 9, I will thank you forever because you have done it. Psalm 63, 3, because of your steadfast love. Because your steadfast love is better than life, my lips shall praise you. In other words, he's saying, we say thank you because somebody has either done something for us or given something to us. And when somebody does something for us or gives something to us, we say thank you. We offer thanksgiving. So thanksgiving is a response. Now then, if thanksgiving is a response, then the lack of thanksgiving reveals something in our lives. When there is a lack of thanksgiving, it tells something about us. One of three things is true in my life and in your life. If there is a lack of thanksgiving, number one, it would be because we haven't got anything. If nobody's done anything for us or given anything to us, there would be no thanksgiving. And so, if there is no thanksgiving in your life, if there's no thankfulness in your life, it will be because you have not received anything. Or second, because you have not valued what you did receive. It was just a little, you know, you gave me a piece of gum, so I may not say thank you for that piece of gum. I never would have given it to all of you. You know, if it's something that's a fact, we have a tendency to be thankful for it, but before, if we think it's something that's not a fact. Or the third reason that we wouldn't be thankful is because we've forgotten. You haven't forgotten anything? Yeah. You forgot. Somebody did something for you or did something to you, and you forgot all of that, so that if you're not thankful, you do not have an attitude of thanksgiving. So in light of those three things, here's what I want us to do this morning. I want us to unfold, remember Psalm 119, 130, the unfolding of your word gives life, it gives understanding to the simple. So I want us to unfold some scriptures, because in the unfolding of these scriptures, we will discover one of those three things. We will discover, number one, that we have things that we didn't know we had. You know, we weren't aware of. We need to have revealed to us that there are some things that God has done for us and God has given to us that we just didn't even recognize at that time. Or secondly, we will find some things here that we did not give real value to, but they are indeed very valuable. They're very important. Or number three, we will be reminded of some things that we have forgotten. And so if we unfold these scriptures, I want the Holy Spirit to do these things in our life, to give to us some revelation, to give to us some recognition, to give gives us a re-evaluation of the things that we have. The first thing that we want to look at is in Psalm 19, verse 24, a verse that you're probably pretty familiar with. The psalmist says, "This is the day which the Lord has made. This is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad." All right? This is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. And why are we to rejoice and be glad in it? Because we know something. Okay. For example, let me give you an illustration. Some of you younger people know that next month, on the 25th, there will be a day. And on that day, there will be excitement and joy, and you'll be rejoicing. Why? Because you know something. You know that there's going to be some gifts given, and there's going to be some good food and fun and fellowship and all those things happening. And so because you know something, then you rejoice in it. You're rejoicing today because you know that after we get through, there's going to be a good meal, and we're going to enjoy it together. And then later this week, we'll be coming together as families for Thanksgiving times, and you'll get to enjoy it. So this is the day. This is the day the Lord made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it because we know something. Now, with that in mind, look a little bit further in the book of Psalms, down to Psalm 139. And David is describing there some things. Notice what he says in verse 16. "Your eyes saw my unformed substance, for I was in form. God's eyes saw me. And in your book were written, every one of them, the days that were formed for me, when as yet there was none of them."
Well, what does that mean?
Right, that simply means this. God wrote in his book, and God designed in his book, before ever you were born, that this day was made especially for you. This is the day the Lord made. We shall rejoice and be glad. One of the reasons we rejoice and be glad is because
it was custom made.
God said, okay, there are things about this particular day that I want to be especially and significantly true for God. And I make it just for him, just for today. It is a custom made thing. And that's true of you too. Today, God has things that God designed for every you were born and wrote in the book that would be true just exactly for you. That's what he says right here. He says, every one of them, every day, that day was formed for me when as yet there was none of them. It was custom made for me and you. Now, add to that what James says over in James chapter 1. He says, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. God, now, put all these things together, okay? Understanding is putting pieces together. And it says, as we unfold your scripture, you give light and you give understanding. So let's put these pieces together for just a minute, all right? We are at the time of the year when we're thinking about giving thanks, Thanksgiving. And here is one of the main things for you and I to fight for. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. It was made specifically and especially for you. It was a custom made for you. It is a gift from God. And the Bible says that every good gift and every perfect gift comes down from God. So this is a good gift. It is a perfect gift. It is a gift from God. It is a gift God has given to you, and it has your name on it. Now, on Christmas morning, you're going to get those gifts out there. You're going to look and you're going to see whose name is on this box. And then you give to the person whose name is on that box that for them to open. That's their gift. And you're looking for one that has your name on it because that's your gift. All right? This day has your name on it. This day has your name on it. This is a special day just exactly for you. Now, remember this. We're going to do some things a little bit later that's going to be important. But remember that this is the day the Lord has made. You shall rejoice and be glad in it because this is the day that came from God, and every gift from God is good and perfect, and it has your name on it, and it's specifically custom made just for you. Now, in light of that, let's look and see what the good gifts that God gives to us, every good, the good gift, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. All right? Here's it. God has given you this day, it's custom made. God has given you eternal life. Those of you who have believed and trusted in Christ as your Savior, he has given you eternal life. And if you notice the tense of the verb, whosoever shall have, you have that right now. You understand? This is not something that you're looking for that's going to happen when you get to heaven. This is something that you have right now. In this custom-made day that God has given you, you have eternal life. It began the moment you trusted Christ as your Savior. He gave you eternal life. A life that will never end. A life that is eternal. See, there will come a day when there will be an obituary that says, God has died. Don't believe it. I'm not dead. My body might not be functioning, but I'm alive. I have eternal life. This is the gift that God has given to me. And I am thankful for this day. I'm thankful this day that it's custom made, just especially for me. And I'm thankful that in this day, right now, I have eternal life. And then you go down a bit further to John 10:10. Jesus said, I've come that you might have life and that you might have more abundantly. Not only do I have eternal life, an abundant life. Jesus said, I've come that you might have life and that you might have it abundantly. That it would be full. It would be overflowing. And so in this day that we rejoice in this day that's custom made just for you, this is a day when I have eternal life, I have abundant life, and we rejoice and we're glad in it because we know something. We know God has said, I will never forsake you. I'll never leave you alone. God has said, okay, I have made this day for you. Listen, today, this Sunday, is where you just in this day, you have eternal life. You have abundance. In this day, I have promised that I will cause everything. Listen, I will cause everything. God says, I want you to know, I'm the one who's in control. And I made this happen. I've justified the world. I gave my son so that you could have eternal life. And I want you to know that in my power and my grace and my strength, I'm going to cause everything in this day, I'm going to cause everything in this day to work together so that. Those things intended for evil, God will use them for good. You may not understand it. I don't understand it. But I believe what God says. God says, I will cause you to work together. And I want you to know that in the meantime, as you're going through all of that, that my goodness and my mercy shall follow you every day of your life. There it says, his goodness and mercy, his power and trust follows us every day of our life. So that today, what you can do, as you go through the day and things begin to happen in the day, all you have to do is stop, turn around and say, Lord, what can see?
Amen.
Goodness and mercy are right here with me. They're following me every day of my life. And so, the God who created the world in the beginning is the God who made the day. God, you know, in the evening, morning, on the first day of the second day, and we rejoice because this is the day, the Lord made. Nobody made this day except God. This was a gift God gave you this morning when you woke up. Alright? This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice to be made in it. I will rejoice to be made in it because it is custom made. It's got my
my name on it. God knows every need, every hurt, every burden, every concern, every desire, every joy. He says, I know this is a custom-made day just for you. It's a good gift. It's a perfect gift. And all these things I have for you in my gift. And then last of all, I want you to know this. He who began a good work in you will be faithful to do it. Okay? You understand that? He who began it. He was the author. He was the creator of this day. This is the day of the Lord. It's a day that's been custom made. It's a day that's filled with just awesome gifts. Awesome gifts. And his promises. All these things are true, and indeed they are. Why would there be a lack of thanksgiving in our life today? Why would there be? See, we talked earlier about we're not lacking because we didn't ever get anything. We got it. We're not lacking because what we got is not valuable. Listen, what we got is we have it. And then we're not lacking because we forgot. What if you forgot? That just reminds you. We've got every reason in the world to let thanks. Man, this is a beautiful thing that God has done for us. Every good and perfect gift that God has for us, He has given to us. And it's ours to rejoice in today. Every day of my life is filled with all these things. I got to think about that. Thursday morning, about 3 o'clock. I was thinking about this. God, I just thought about it. And I said, you know, that's amazing. But I don't always sense that's true. Sometimes in my life, there's a blankness. Something is wrong. I mean, all these things are true. All these things are they unfold in God's word. And they give light and they give understanding. So what, you know, what's wrong? God, have I messed up your name? This is the very Lord thing. Rejoice today. I've got somebody for you. God, I messed up your name. I didn't hear God call. He didn't talk out like Jonah didn't hear him yelling through the house. But I heard him just as clear. He didn't take the final word and spoke right into it. God, don't kid yourself. You can't mess up. You can't mess up. Now let me tell you what you can do. You can mess up your blessings. See, the things that I have given to you, this is the day of the Lord today. You should rejoice and be glad that it's custom made for you. And in John 3:16, believe in the Lord, He's your Savior. And now you have eternal life, you have eternal life. All these things. Signed, sealed, they're secure, they cannot be taken away. Your salvation is secure, but your blessings. See, we're not saved by works, but our blessings are a different thing. You can mess up your blessings. Your blessings are determined by your position and your practice. Your blessings are determined by whether you are walking in agreement with God. Walking walk with them. And the other thing is your practice, what you're doing, whether that walk is the word. So you can bless up your message, your message, but you can't bless up that day, bless up that day. Because that day still has all of your blessings in it. But we are diminished because we have been walking and believing and being in the way we ought to. I said, wow. Okay. I had messed up some messages. But here's one last verse. Steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. In other words, okay, you messed up the message yesterday, guess what? Here's a new day. Every day I've given you a new day, and every day that I give you a new day is the day that I've made, and that day is custom made, and it still has all these blessings for you, and my mercy is never fade. My grace is with you every day. My love never ceases. And when we fully realize, listen, when we fully realize what God has done and God is doing, we'll just be content. Thank you. As a matter of fact, Paul said, giving thanks always for everything. Hebrews said, let us continually offer up a sacrifice of praise to God. So we're continuing praising God because we know God is faithful. We may not be faithful, but God is. Great is His faithfulness. They are reviewed afresh every day. Bella Gloria gave a little song. Fully alive in your spirit. Lord, make me fully alive. Fully aware of your presence, Lord. Totally, fully alive. Don't let me miss all the glory around me waiting for heaven someday to come. Open my eyes to miraculous light and make my feet march to eternity. Don't let me wait for some fall off forever to say what I feel for the ones I want to hear. Risking the pain and the joy of love. Keep me awake and alive. Fully alive. That's a good course. You know it. It's appropriate, not just Thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Thank you, Lord, for me. Thank you, Lord, for giving to me your great salvation. So full. Thank you. Pray that we might walk in agreement, worthy.